I mean, they're so fun to make, to be honest. They're so challenging, you know, physically, emotionally, mentally. You really have to push yourself to the limits of what the human body can do sometimes. And it's such a rewarding feeling. And I just find it fantastically entertaining to perform and also to watch. So it's kind of a win-win for me, really. So it's a direct prequel to the original Omen. We find our story somewhere around 7 years before the original takes place. And yeah, it just slots right on in there. It tells you the story of what came before this movie that we all us horror fans have grown to fear and love so much. Yeah, tough to do without spoilers. Well, I suppose everyone's seen that. Of course, we have the iconic "It's all for you" line performed brilliantly by Ishtar Wilson, who gave her whole soul to this movie. And we had, there's definitely a few more, some little Easter eggs in there that you've got to kind of discover for yourself. But I think mostly it's like the way that Akasha filmed this and shot this, it has such a nostalgic feel. And the energy of it, I feel, at least personally, and the tone of it feels like it's definitely echoes the original as best as, you know, we can do in these times. So yes, I think that hopefully it will feel like it fits. Oh, wow. I mean, again, without giving spoilers, the creepiest part of this story is that, for me, that's actually a good question. I haven't been asked that what I personally find to be the creepiest. I think the fact that all of these people have this purpose for this one person, and this one person is completely unaware of it, and it's almost like you've been farmed, like you've been cattled and raised for one specific reason, and to have your entire life be dictated by that, and your entire life has been dictated by something that you are completely unaware of. I think that's like very chilling and spine tingling, and something that would scare me very much. Yeah, she is a young novitiate. She's coming to become a nun in Rome, all the way from Pittsfield, Massachusetts, under the guidance of Bill Nye's character, Father Lawrence, who sort of like a father figure to her, very paternal energy from him towards her. And she's going to work at an orphanage there. And it all seems quite lovely and picturesque and beautiful and emotional and sweet. And then things start to take a turn for the worse quite quickly, and everything kind of begins to crumble around her.